Hey there, guys. How's it going? Long time no see. Haven't talked on this channel in a little while, but I wanted to talk about Black Ops 6. Honestly, I've been looking at other people's reactions to the game, and I think it's a little harsh. A little not. I mean, I'm fully on agreeance with Zombies mode. It's, we got, you know, Terminus. Looks like a cool, new, exciting, really sick map. And then we got Liberty Balls that literally looks like they took a Warzone segment of a map, cut it out, like all the MW2 and MW3 maps pretty much, stuck it together, and what we got was Liberty Balls. It looks like a multiplayer map. I still haven't seen the HUD adjustments that people are talking about. I hope there's something that's close to Black Ops 3 that would make Zombies mode pretty fun. I'm not, like an old zombies purist, but I guess we could talk about the zombies mode first real quick and go over what I think about it. I do think it's gonna be pretty good. I mean, we should get a third map before the end of the year. It's been and still is, even after playing the multiplayer, it's something I'm hoping is just gonna be fucking fun, dude. I enjoy zombies a lot. I'm a little indifferent about them adding the gobble gums back. I never had fun with gobble gums when you had to get them legit in Black Ops 3. It does seem like, from what I've heard, we can get the gobble gums a little quicker, or like every passing round in Black Ops 6. Doesn't mean it's going to be good gobble gums, but I'm sure every like 5 or 8 rounds in a zombies match, you're going to get like a decent legendary or something. Cause I don't think they said there's going to be any way to buy them. I kind of doubt that though. I mean, they already have it in the deluxe edition. If you bought the $100 edition, you would have gotten like 12 or 25 gobble gums. I don't know how I feel about that. The new Terminus map, like I said, it looks amazing. You get a set crew again, finally. And it's something that we haven't had since Black Ops 4. Granted, I can't talk too much on Black Ops 4, as that's a game that I gave up on pretty much immediately. I think I was just falling out of Call of Duty at that point. I played so much of it throughout the years, and Black Ops 4, a lot of people, they have different views on it. Some people say that's what zombies should have been. We had what we always wanted, and we threw it all away. Other people, I mean, just looking at that HUD on Black Ops 4, geez, it looks rough. I would say it's, no matter what, we wouldn't have had the zombies we wanted, probably. I have seen people, though, for Liberty Balls, they're holding out hope, myself included, I'm holding out hope, that the map has something kind of akin to what's in Black Ops 4. I forgot the exact name of the map, but it looked like Nuketown, and I guess you could go underground and there was a whole, you know, zombies situation happening. You know, 115, all the weird stuff. I'm sure maybe in Liberty Balls we'll have like some way of going underground and the Aether is going to be down there or whatever. Samantha in that giant ball, right? I think that's what people are saying, that Samantha's in a big ball. I'll take Samantha in a big ball all day. You know, that sounds interesting. It sounds much more interesting than Firebase Z. I'm not going to lie to you. Multiplayer wise though, kind of getting pretty hyped. I really like the new movement. I just went back to MW3 earlier today and I was playing a little bit of that, getting some gameplay of it, and it felt stupid to strafe with just walking, you know what I mean? Look, going left to right and right to left, it didn't feel right. Black Ops 6 movement, I'm enjoying it. It feels like something they should have done probably a long time ago, but I mean, better late than never, I guess. Another big thing, at least for me, I guess I'm a Call of Duty old head, but with the multiplayer, they're adding back in a normal old prestige system, so no more having to wait depending on your fucking battle pass season. I'm pretty much gonna ignore the damn battle pass this year, and I'm gonna level up when I want to. Sadly, I'm not gonna be able to join every single, you know, double XP weekend, because I don't, you know, I'm on off every single weekend, but damn, yeah, no, it excites me, the fact that I'm going to be able to go through 15 prestiges, and I'm going to say it now, I'm going to try, maybe I'll touch back on this channel by the end of next year or something, and before the next Call of Duty comes out, did I hit max prestige? We will find out. I bet you one of my friends will, just because they go hard like that. But yeah, no, I'm going to try to hit max prestige. That shit's going to be exciting. I'm going to try and get the mastery camos. I think that'll be interesting. I know Treyarch is a little finicky, and they like to, you know, do your get kills with enemies behind cover, enemies, you know, wiping their asshole or something, and shoot them. But as long as they don't have some of that bullshit in there, I'm getting mastery camos. I'm definitely going to go for them on the zombie side. I think I'm going to play a lot of zombies. I actually did forget to mention one thing with zombies real quick. I guess this is a little out there, but in single-player games, since the game's going to be online only, which I do have issues with, but I guess if this is what they're going to do, you can save and quit in a solo zombies match. Oh my god, dude. I'm going to be playing so much zombies. But to back on track to the multiplayer side, I mean, guns that I used in the beta feels good. Gunplay feels good. Game feels smooth. Everything seems like it's coming together. And I might come back on like the launch, around the launch of Call of Duty Black Ops 6, maybe a week after. I also heard that possibly we're not going to be able to play the campaign a week early. I might not even play the campaign. I know that sounds rough. Maybe I'll touch it in a month or two later, but I'm mostly going to be grinding multiplayer. I'm pretty excited for it. I'm not going to be focusing on battle passes because I don't care about that crap. The Black Cell, it is whatever. If they really like introduce some cool shit, then it's like, maybe I'll have to get this one. But really, I mean, there's a new Call of Duty every single year. Usually the Call of Duties die. They especially die on PC pretty quick with like hacking and other situations. But I mean, I guess console has to deal with that too with crossplay. So we're all in the same boat now. You guys asked for this, maybe. I remember asking for it when I was on console. I thought crossplay was the best thing in the world, but it was between Xbox and PlayStation. Now it doesn't really matter because it's just like people just own PlayStations. I know people own Xboxes too, but it's not that serious. But yeah, no, I'm looking forward to Black Ops 6. I'm looking forward to maybe, I'm not going to make a promise, but maybe uploading more videos a little consistently. If I could talk off the cuff and off the riff, I have been thinking about wanting to talk about Sony, and I've been wanting to talk about Nintendo. I just don't know if I'll be able to put in a full, complete video where I'm making any semblance of sense. Basically, I could recommend Black Ops 6 from what I played in the beta. I think it's exciting. I think it's going to be fun. I've seen a lot of stupid takes. It's a Call of Duty game that's moving forward ever so gradually. It's been doing it for years. You either like them or you don't. I haven't enjoyed particularly MW2 the most. I didn't enjoy it that much. I also just didn't play a lot of MW3, mostly because I don't have like major nostalgia for Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2, even though that's one of the major games I played. I have more nostalgia for like the original Black Ops and Call of Duty Black Ops 2. Black Ops 2 easily would be probably my biggest nostalgia. And that game's, it's getting up there. It's getting like 12, 13 years old. I wish we'd get a Black Ops 2 remaster from what I'm hearing. It's not going to happen. So Black Ops 6, though, I'm liking it. I'm very excited to actually get my hands on it in the end of October.